Yo, what's up, guys? It's your boy Maurice here. We're back for another video today, and I got something special for you guys today. Today, we're gonna be doing Metacooler and his return. Now, if you remember a while back, we did Cooler's Revenge, right? Well, today, I wanted to finish the Cooler saga, and we're gonna be talking about how Cooler returned and put the beats on both Goku and Vegeta and ultimately embarrassed them. Let's talk about it. Dude, we have to get this out of the way right now. Cooler had probably one of the best comebacks we've ever seen, bro. So, last time we saw Cooler, he was pretty much getting cooked by the sun, right? Well, when we see him again in the next movie, not only did he come back to life, he came back to life even better, bro. And also, not only that, bro enslaved a whole planet as well. So, not only did he come back, he also got his get back as well. Like, bro, this man is all the way different just for that. But you already know Goku had to stop that shit, bro. Because, dude, him and his friends, they saw what was happening on Namek. They're like, oh, nah, fuck this shit. And so they went to Namek, and then, yeah, bro, Goku and Cooler started to face off with each other on Namek. And this, honestly, bro, I gotta say right now, this is probably one of the best fights I've ever seen. This fight right here that's about to happen is legendary. So the fight starts off with them talking shit, right? Of course, you know, this is the first time Goku has seen Cooler in a while, so you know, they're just, you know, talking their shit, and then they start fighting, and we see that Goku, even in his base form, he can sort of, and I mean sort of, you know, keep up with Metacooler even in his base form. But then we see that Cooler wasn't really trying, right? So once Cooler starts to try, that's also when Goku starts to try, and he goes Kaioken, and he starts to put the beats on him a little bit. But even with Kaioken, it's still obvious that he's under Cooler, and Cooler soon starts to show Goku why he is just simply not that guy in this fight, and he starts to beat the fuck, and I mean the fuck, out of Goku. And so after a while, Goku's like, all right, you know what, fuck this shit, I'm going Super Saiyan. And so bro goes Super Saiyan, and then this is where things get a little bit interesting. This is where they for real start swinging at each other, and after this, everything is S tier, right? I just want to get that out of the way, bro. So, dude, they start fighting, bro. Goku's a Super Saiyan, fucking, you know, this dude Cooler came back, literally encased in metal, and so, dude, they literally start fighting each other, and this is honestly better than Goku versus Frieza on Namek. I'll just say it right now, but yeah, dude. After a while, Goku starts to get tired of this, and he flies at Cooler so fast and he punches him so hard that he completely takes off the entire right side of his body, right? And so he turns around thinking that he just did something, and then Cooler's like, ah, psych, nigga, you thought, and then he starts to regenerate. That is completely different. We've never seen Cooler do some shit like this, so this just shows that Goku is in for a real treat with this fight. And then soon after Cooler's done regenerating, that's when him and Goku start talking shit again, right? And then they start fighting, and then, dude, out of nowhere, Cooler just, like, dude, he starts beating the fuck out of Goku again. Like, dude, he puts bro in, like, a fucking, you know, Call of Duty execution move or some shit. This dude was putting the beats on him, right? And so Goku fired a Kamehameha at him, and that shit did nothing, bro. That shit literally went right through him. It did nothing. He ate that shit for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and then wanted more after that. Like, bro, he was tanking Kamehamehas before it was cool, bro. Like, dude, he did that shit before Broly did. Like, bro, Cooler is a trendsetter for real, right? And so, yeah, bro, soon after this, you already know who showed up, bro. Our boy Vegeta, the L Magnet himself, showed up, and then he takes L's. I mean, what else did you expect, you know? By the way, I've always wondered this. How the fuck did Vegeta get here? Did he take a ship? Did he learn instant transmission? How the hell did bro get here? Like, dude, he literally just showed up out of nowhere. He showed up because the plot demanded him to show up. But I mean, at the same time, who cares? Because not even the fucking plot cares about him, because as soon as he charges at Cooler, bro gets bitch smacked, and he doesn't even get to put a hand on Cooler, bro. This man, dude, he literally looked at him, charged at him, thought he was about to do something, and then Kohler said, "Get the fuck out of my face. You're not even worth my time." Like, once again, that's an L. And then to top off this L, he also got kicked in the fucking dick by Kohler. Dude, Kohler took it to the next level. He made it personal with this attack, bro. He literally, out of nowhere, just kicked Vegeta in the fucking nuts. Just because, bro. And so soon after this, Goku and Vegeta realize that they need a combined effort of their attacks in order to take down Kohler, because at the rate he can regenerate, they have to hurt him faster than he can, you know, regenerate. And so that's exactly what they do. They just start throwing a fuck ton of energy blasts at bro, and they are not letting up. They are literally jumping him with energy blasts, and they keep doing this until he dies, or so they think. And so after they turn Kohler into scrap metal, Goku and Vegeta start to celebrate because they think they won. They think they're about to walk. Like, bro, they think they're about to walk off into the fucking sunset, and then the fucking, you know, end credits are gonna roll. Nah, bro, not that easy. Dude, this man Kohler pops up out of nowhere with like a bunch of other Kohlers, and they just start to run at Goku and Vegeta, and they are about to jump them. They are really about to jump these niggas, bro. And so Goku and Vegeta, they power up. Like, bro, they really think they're about to take on 1,000 Meta Coolers when they could barely take on one, bro. They power up, and then, like, bro, they don't even let us see the fight. They don't even let us see, like, bro, they take an L so badly, we do not get to see it. They literally power up, and then they cut to them fucked up, tied up. Like, bro, you could tell Kohler put them through some shit, bro. They got their asses beat. And so, yeah, bro, Kohler has them right where he wants them. Like, bro, they're just hanging right there, and he has them right where he wants them, and he's just talking shit. Dude, he is enjoying every moment of this. And right when Kohler thought shit was sweet, right as he thought that he was about to win, that's when Goku and Vegeta, they start to power up, and the energy from them powering up causes his system to overload. And when his system overloads, this causes all of the other Meta Coolers that he made, which I think he said he made like 1,000 of them. Dude, every single one of them got fucked up. They all died because his system got overloaded. And then soon after this, Goku and Vegeta were free. And so after this, Kohler realizes that he is utterly fucked. And so he literally turns into a fucking Titan from like Attack on Titan or some shit, and then he starts running at Goku, and Goku tries to fire an energy blast, but Kohler, he still has some of his power left, and so he uses some of his like I guess it's like metal wiring. He pretty much wraps Goku in his metal wiring, and this stops Goku from throwing his energy blast. But then Vegeta comes in clutch. He takes a rare W, and he cuts off Kohler's arm that was holding Goku, and so now Goku can kill Kohler and fire the energy blast at him, and then this kills Kohler, and then that is finally the end of our boy Kohler. He is done with his reign, sadly. And with that, I am done with my video. If you like this video, please leave a like and subscribe, and as always, share the video with your friends. Let's grow the channel. I'm trying to reach 500 subscribers very soon. I am almost there. Let's get there, all right? And yeah, if you have any other video topics you want me to talk about, please let me know down in the comments below, and I will definitely do my best to talk about them. And yeah, if you like the video, leave a like, and with that, I'll see you later. Peace.